Yeah, thank you very much, Dirk. I'm a specialist, an internist and a specialist in laboratory medicine. I trained in medicine in Dublin, and I've worked in Dublin and England, in London, and also here for many years in Germany. And in my statement, I want to address not the medical and scientific problems that the other speakers have mentioned, but to draw attention to problems with novel therapies such as mRNA vaccines, as these apply to small countries like Ireland. As an Irish physician working in Germany, I've been able to compare the response to the mRNA vaccines in both countries. About 85% of the Irish population received a COVID vaccine, most of whom received an mRNA vaccine. And even though the same adverse effects were seen in Ireland as were seen in other countries, as have been mentioned here, the response in Ireland has been very muted. Although there's been almost no response from the authorities in Ireland to these problems, much less than even in Germany. And it has been very difficult to gain access to data, for example, on adverse effects on mortality, on fertility, from official sources. As small countries like Ireland are often used as laboratories for testing novel therapies. This is of particular relevance in Ireland because Ireland is the site of manufacturing for many large pharmaceutical companies, which have a great deal of influence on the Irish government. The mRNA vaccine problem is international in scope and needs to be addressed internationally, as small countries like Ireland don't have the resources financially, politically, scientifically to deal with this. So this is a most important initiative because the fruits of this can also be applied to countries like Ireland that are not able to face a problem like this on their own. Thank you very much.